Cytology. Cytology is a diagnostic technique used to examine cells from various body fluids and solid tissues to determine the nature of disease. It includes three types of sampling. 1. Exfoliative cytology. Spontaneously shed cells in body fluids. For example, urine, sputum, CSF and effusions, such as pleural, pericardial or peritoneal effusions. 2. Abrasive cytology. Dislodges cells from the body surfaces and mucosal linings. Example, cervical scrape cytology, such as pap smear, scrapings, bronchular washings, swabs, etc. 3. Aspirational cytology. Aspirates cells from palpable lump or mass anywhere in the body using a needle with or without suction. It is commonly called FNAC or fine needle aspiration cytology. It can be done directly for palpable lumps or under ultrasound or CT guidance for mass which is not palpable. Stains used in cytopathology. 1. Papanicolaou stain or PAP stain is the most important stain used in the practice of cytopathology. It is used for both cervical smears and exfoliative cytology smears. 2. Romanowski stains. GEMSA, MGG, that is May Grunwald GEMSA, or Leishman stains are used for FNACs and for fluids. 3. H and E stain is also used in fluids and FNACs. The H and E stain is mainly a histopathology stain and has been described in that section. PAP smears are generally stained by PAP staining, which will be described in this section. Sample collection. Sample for FNAC is generally collected by the pathologists. The activity depends on the site being aspirated. To explain the technique is beyond the scope of this video. PAP smears are mostly collected by gynecologists. Ayer's spatula and endocervical brushes are used for collection. Sampling of transformation zone is vital to the reporting of PAP smears. More about this can be read in the QC module. Fluids are collected by clinicians and sent to the lab. The processing of the fluids is explained in the video of fluid analysis. Preparations from the cellular material can be in the form of direct smears of the material on slides. This is the commonest and easiest. Cytospin preparation, membrane filter preparation, liquid-based preparation, cell blocks. For more about sample collection, please see the sample collection and pre-analytical best practices module. Slide preparation and fixing. All smear preparations are made on clean glass slides and fixed in ethanol or methanol or spray fixed or air dried depending on the stain to be used. Ethanol fixation is wet fixation and is done by immediately immersing the prepared slides into 95% ethanol held in Copeland jars. Air-dried smears are required for some stains like MGG used in FNAC smears. They are later wet fixed in methyl alcohol for 15 to 20 minutes during the straining process. Spray fixation done using cytosprays is employed in many labs as an easier alternative to wet fixation. The smears are air-dried before fixation. However, the cellular characteristics are better preserved if the spray is used as the edges of the smear begin to dry. The angle of spraying is important. The distance between the nozzle and the smear should be about 15 to 25 centimeters. If the fixative bottle is held too close, the cells can be dislodged from the smear. And if held too far away, sufficient amount of fixative will not reach the smear. Too forceful spraying can also create cellular artifacts by fracturing of the cytoplasm. An ideal angle for spraying is 45 degrees. Sample transportation. Slide mailers are most suited for sample transportation. Well-fixed, adequately labeled slides can be safely transported using slide mailers. Pap stain. Papanicolaou stain or pap stain is the most important stain utilized in cervical cytology. It is a polychromatic stain containing multiple dyes to differentially stain various components of the cells. This technique was developed by George Papanicolaou, the father of cytopathology. Principle: Pap stains have acid dye which stains the basic components of cells and a basic dye which stains the acid components of cells. The main objective of pap staining is defining of nuclear details. Because of the widespread nuclear abnormalities of cancer cells and their diagnostic significance, good staining of the nucleus is of primary importance. Nuclei are stained by hematoxylin solution. Transparency of cytoplasm. This is of particular importance because of the varying thickness and the frequent overlapping of cells. Orange G stain is used as the cytoplasmic stain. Differentiation of cells. Differences in the staining reaction, such as that between acidophilic and basophilic cells, help greatly in the identification of certain cell types found in smears. Polychromatic solution. A mixture of eosin Y, light green SF, and Bismarck brown Y is used for demonstration of differentiation of squamous cells. Reagents. Harris hematoxylin. Natural dye hematoxylin is the nuclear stain which stains cell nuclei blue. It has affinity for chromatin attaching to the sulfate groups on the DNA molecule. Harris hematoxylin is the commonest, the others being Gill's hematoxylin and hematoxylin S. Orange green 6. This is the first acidic counterstain, cytoplasmic stain, which stains matured and keratinized cells. The target structures are stained orange in different intensities. Eosin Azure or EA50. This is the second counterstain, which is a polychrome mixture of eosin Y, light green SF, and Bismarck brown. Eosin Y gives a pink color to cytoplasm of mature squamous cells, nucleoli, cilia, and red blood cells. Light green SF stains blue to the cytoplasm of metabolically active cells like parabasal squamous cells, intermediate squamous cells, and columnar cells. Bismarck brown Y stains nothing but stabilizes the staining. There are three types of pap stain: 1. Progressive, 2. Regressive, 3. Rapid. Progressive method. In the progressive method, the nucleus is stained with hematoxylin to an intensity desired. The intensity of the nuclear staining is controlled by the immersion of the slide into a bluing agent. The most commonly used bluing agent is Scott's tap water with a pH of 8.02. Regressive method. In the regressive staining method, the nucleus is deliberately overstained with a non-acidified hematoxylin. The excess stain is removed with dilute hydrochloric acid solution or acid water. The decolorizing process is then stopped by immersing the slide in running tap water. Timing is crucial in the regressive method as destaining may lead to a hyperchromatic nucleus becoming hypochromatic. Steps of progressive staining. 95% alcohol for fixation, 15 to 30 minutes. Hydration in 4 steps. 80% alcohol, 2 minutes. 60% alcohol, 2 minutes. In the first Copland jar of distilled water, 5 dips. And in the second Copland jar of distilled water, 5 dips. Hematoxylin stain, 3 minutes. Wash gently in running water for 30 seconds. Bluing with Scott's tap water, 3 minutes. Dehydration in 4 steps. Distilled water, 3 minutes. 60% alcohol, 2 minutes. 80% alcohol, 2 minutes. 95% alcohol, 2 minutes. Orange G stain, 3 minutes. Dip in the first Copland jar of 95% alcohol for 2 minutes. And again dip in the second Copland jar of 95% alcohol for 2 minutes. Eosin Azure stain, 3 minutes. Dip in the first Copland jar of 95% alcohol for 2 minutes. And again dip in the second Copland jar of 95% alcohol for 2 minutes. Dip in the first Copland jar of absolute alcohol for 2 minutes. And again dip in the second Copland jar of absolute alcohol for 2 minutes. Clearing in 3 stages. Absolute alcohol plus xylene in a proportion of 1:1, 2 minutes. Dip in the first Copland jar of xylene for 2 minutes. And again dip in the second Copland jar of xylene for 2 minutes. Corn flake artifact. If the xylene evaporates completely, it will lead to what we call a corn flake artifact. So, allow it to dry partially after taking it out from the xylene. Mount in DPX. Mounting of slide. The mounting media must be miscible with the clearing agent to prevent fading of the stains. Practice is essential to achieve well-mounted slides free of air bubbles and artifacts. A minimum of mounting medium should be used. Too much mounting medium interferes with microscopic detail, making the cell film appear hazy or milky when examined under the high-power microscope. The usual size of the cover slip for a cervical smear is 22 by 30 mm. If the smear spread is beyond the cover slip area, ideally use another small cover slip or put a drop of DPX and spread evenly with the same cover slip without affecting the focus. The color of the stain. Nuclei will be stained blue, acidophilic cells red, basophilic cells blue-green, erythrocytes orange-red, keratin orange-red, superficial cells pink, intermediate and parabasal cells blue-green, eosinophils orange-red, candida red, trichomonas gray-green. Precautions. Immediate fixation of smears is essential. All solutions and other stains are to be filtered daily after use to keep them free of sediment. Alcohols are hygroscopic and will absorb moisture from air, especially in humid climates. So if alcohols are left open, the concentration percent decreases and appropriate dehydration cannot be achieved. Keep them covered. Avoid contamination from one smear to another. Stains are discarded and replaced as the quality of the stain deteriorates. Place the cover slip on the microslide slowly, without trapping air bubbles. Stains keep longer if they are stored in dark-colored, stoppered bottles. Points to remember. All stains and alcohol changes will depend on load. Any solution which is hazy and turbid should be discarded. All stain changes should be protocoled and logged. Hematoxylin keeps relatively constant staining characteristics and does not require frequent discarding if small amounts of fresh stain are added to replace the stain loss due to evaporation. OG and EA stains lose strength more rapidly than hematoxylin and should be replaced each week or as soon as the cells appear without crisp staining colors. Bluing solution and HCl should be replaced at least once daily. Water rinses should be changed after each use. Alcohol used for the process of dehydration prior to the cytoplasmic stains may be replaced weekly. The alcohol rinses following the cytoplasmic stains are usually changed on a rotating basis after each use. The alcohol rinse immediately following the stain is discarded, and the other two rinses are moved to the first and second position, and fresh unused alcohol is replaced in the second last position. Ideally, this rotation must continue after each staining run. The absolute alcohols should be changed weekly and can be kept water-free by adding silica gel pellets. Xylene should be changed as soon as it becomes tinted with any of the cytoplasmic stains. Xylene becomes slightly milky if water is present in it, and if so, the clearing process may be disturbed. Tiny drops of water may be seen microscopically on a plane above the cell on a slide. Stains may have batch-to-batch variation in dye content, requiring change in timing during staining. The quality of the stained slide is dependent on timing, solubility, and percentage of the dye concentration. Maintenance of stains and solutions. Please refer to the QC module also. 1. All reagents, stains, and solutions should be stored as recommended by the manufacturer and used within their indicated expiry dates. 2. The label should bear the following information: content and quantity, concentration or titer, date received or prepared, date of opening, storage requirements, and expiry dates wherever applicable. 3. The laboratory should use adequate controls for reagents, stains to check their performance where a built-in control does not exist. Example, the buccal mucosal smear for pap stain. 4. Reagents and stains should be procured from standard reputed sources. 5. Each lot of reagents shall be checked against earlier tested in-use reagent lots or with suitable reference material before being placed in service, and the results should be recorded.